There is growing reaction tonight to a Global News investigation into RCMP training and preparedness. It stems from last year's deadly shooting of three RCMP officers in Moncton, New Brunswick. Global News spoke with dozens of officers who say they don't have access to proper equipment and training to deal with the most urgent of threats. The RCMP commissioner has dismissed our report, but now, as Jennifer Tryon reports, federal Liberals are calling on Bob Paulsen to testify about the concerns of his frontline officers.
This is the man the federal Liberals feel should be accountable to Canadians, RCMP Commissioner Bob Paulsen.
We're falling so far behind other police forces.
Since Global News first aired the testimonials of officers admitting they didn't have the training or the equipment to keep the public or themselves safe, Mountie management has been silent.
There's something seriously wrong with resourcing issues within the RCMP.
So now, Liberal MP Wayne Easter has put forward a motion inviting Paulsen to testify in front of the Standing Committee on Public Safety and National Security.
And we need answers from the commissioner himself. How is that impacting the ability of the RCMP to do its job? How is it affecting morale within the force? Just the ability to do their job.
Since the 2005 RCMP shooting in Mayerthorpe, Alberta, the Mounties have been promising frontline officers more effective weapons and training, specifically the carbine. It's a semi-automatic weapon that might have allowed officers in Moncton to shoot from a much further distance. Instead, only Justin Bourque had that power.
Three of my friends were dead because the RCMP sat on their hands and did nothing after Mayerthorpe.
The government says it has increased funding to the RCMP 30%.
On an operational basis, how they choose to make those investments is, again, really something that you might best direct towards Commissioner Paulsen.
But what Paulsen has made public is that there's been a shift within the RCMP, that resources have been taken out of criminal police work and put into the government's new priority, terrorism. Meantime, some frontline officers have opted to pay for their own training and bring their own weapons to work.
I knew guys when I started that would carry a military rifle in their trunk.
Unacceptable, says opposition parties who want Canada's top cop to answer for it. Jennifer Tryon, Global News, Toronto.